Watchers, welcome to Perth Watch, your horology channel, broadcasting from right here in Perth, Western Australia. Those of you who follow me on the channel probably know that I've kind of reduced my upload rate to once a week lately. It was just being busy at work with, you know, pandemic and all that. But I wanted to kind of throw this in as an extra video this week because, you know, it's easy enough to do a no-frills video featuring these new straps, which I got in recently. So these are from Strapify. Strapify Australia are relatively new, in fact, about the same age as my channel, about 3 years old, and they've been kind of putting out some different products. And they reached out and I saw these rather different products on the website, so I was keen to have a look at them. And here we are today showing them to you. So the ones on the left here are what they call Marine Nationale straps. So I understand that these are inspired by the French Navy, but I'm not sure exactly how they are inspired. In fact, whether they use the exact same thing, let me know if you are more aware of the history behind Marine Nationale straps than I am. And then these are what they call Cross NATO, and they call it Cross, I think it's because it's a cross between purlin, the feel of it, and kind of a nylon NATO strap. So what we have is, hopefully it comes out in the camera here, it's a fairly nice cross stitching material that they have made this out of. Okay, so this is what the Cross NATO is. One good thing is these days I do like single pass. I don't like traditional double pass NATOs, which kind of lift the watch up off the wrist more than I like, really, and more than most people like. And then the other thing with this is they have this floating keeper and the adjustable, I guess what they call this adjustable strap here. So you can see if I push it out, you can actually adjust the length of the remaining bit here, this extra bit here, to make it shorter or longer depending on your preference, and also get a micro adjust fit, you know, that fits your wrist exactly. So there's a nice little touch, you know, with that particular special buckle that they have there that makes it adjustable. That's why it looks like that. Okay, so let's just show the rest to you. This one is the Cross NATO in Night Blue, right? This one, they call it Mint Green. This one, of course, is just, they call it orange, and that's really what it is. It's a bright orange. And this one they call Desert Sand with a white stripe. They call that a wheat stripe in the middle. Okay, that's really what you're seeing here. The thing about these Marine Nationales is I've really been enjoying wearing this. So this is with my Orient Ray 2 in blue. And, you know, I've matched it with it because blue and orange matches fairly nicely, I think. And the fact that it's got that special blue on the second hand there, a lot of divers have a little splash of blue, and that kind of plays off nicely with the strap. Okay, so that's just, you know, this is how you put it on. And unfortunately, it's not a quick change. You do have to pop off the spring bars and then, you know, put the strap on and then fit the spring bars on top of the strap. So it's not a quick strange strap, much like a NATO would be, but, you know, it's pretty cool. So this is how it sits. This one's an adjustable position here, and what you would do is put your hand through, right, and then flip this bit around. So this bit flips around and then hooks onto this, whatever you call it, a keeper, you know, position holder there. And that's how it would look like. There you go, my Orient Ray with the Marine Nationale in bright orange. And I've quite enjoyed this because it is quite eye-catching, not very formal, of course. So it's a much more casual strap, but people have indeed looked at this watch with the strap on and commented, "Ooh, that's an interesting looking combination you got there." Or in fact, they say interesting looking watch, but what they really, I guess, caught the attention, I'm pretty sure, is actually this strap, you know, and it's got that hook there with Strapify that you can see there. Okay, so that's just that strap there. Let's just take it out. This one on my Boulder Venture Green, really like this watch, you know, because it's small, it's under 40 millimeters. I think it's 36, I think, or 38. But, you know, I've liked having this on this strap. It doesn't exactly match it, but somehow I think it goes very well. Okay, so let's just show this one to you guys, right? Same idea, right? Hook it around to this adjustable position holder there, and that's how it looks, okay? Mint or Desert Sand, I think this one is called. Okay, that's really how it looks. Really nice, really comfortable, right? It gets wet, but it dries very quickly. It's really an all-weather type of strap, which I've really enjoyed. And it really, yeah, the comfort level is excellent, I would say, you know, and the convenience level of this strap in terms of, you know, it's adjustable infinitely and it's easy to put on. All right, now onto the NATO type of buckles. This is my Spinnaker Tessai Titanium, and kind of matched it with the blue. Not exactly matching tone, but close enough. I think, you know, any kind of blue, kind of casual watch, dive watch goes well with this night blue. I think, you know, that's why I chose this particular strap. Now let's just put it on for the wrist shot for you guys. And there we have it, the Tessai Titanium on the Strapify Cross NATO in night blue on my 17 centimeter wrist. Now I'll just show you that I'm on the second largest hole here, and you know, the floating buckle just keeps it. There's the extra buckle, I don't actually need that. You can actually, of course, adjust this to be longer, so you can use some of the middle holes, or if you have a larger wrist than mine, you will definitely need to adjust this longer. So I'll just show you again. Of course, it's a 28 centimeter long strap, right? And some of that length has come into the, you know, I guess the hook around here, the return here. So you can actually pull that out to make it longer if you have a larger wrist. I imagine it would easily accommodate up to 7.5 or maybe slightly larger, probably not more than 8 inches, I think, just looking at the construction of this strap. Okay, so that's really that one. Now this one doesn't match. This is my Invicta ProDiver 9403. This is the only one I had, you know, with the bracelet off, so you know, it was ready to go with a NATO. Doesn't match, but it's just to show you a 20 millimeter NATO on, you know, on this brand, this Cross NATO. So just to clarify as well, I didn't say 22 millimeters, right? That's 20 millimeter, and that one's 22, and this one is 20. Okay, so I've got 20 and 22 varieties of this strap. Okay, so just to show this on the wrist shot for you guys now. And there we are, the Invicta 40 millimeter Pro Diver with the Strapify Cross NATO strap on my wrist there. And just to point out, you can see it's the same length, but this one I'm using hole number 4 because it's in a different adjusted position, and I can actually fit it into the fixed keeper there as well as the floating keeper, right, that one. So, you know, really nice that you can adjust it to your preference and micro adjust this buckle, the position of this buckle, to fit your wrist, you know, really perfectly. If you really want that, you know, millimeter adjustment, it's possible with this NATO, which is a really nice thing. That's one of the strengths, I think, of the design that they've gone with. All right, so there you go, guys. Strapify Australia products. Give them a look, particularly if you're an Aussie, you know, always happy to support Aussie companies. These are the most different straps that they have, you know, something I've never seen, I haven't had on the channel, this style of straps, which is very interesting to me to feature. So hopefully you guys found that quick video in this midweek interesting. Guys, thank you again for watching. If you enjoy my videos, of course, consider subscribing. New content weekly, always aiming to be objective and unbiased about all things horology. Thank you again for sticking with me. And as always, I'll catch you guys next time.